Phoenix Country.
Phoenix begins, at least its physical beginning. Actually, the program of design and engineering on the Phoenix dates back several years. We wanted our Phoenix to have full and complete control and yet have extended glide range and increased lift capability. During the design life of the Phoenix, we found the perfect combination of keel length, wingspan, and general wing design. What developed was a kite with superb response and pitch control, excellent penetration even under high wind conditions. In short, a glider that gives the pilot complete confidence and maneuverability. We are circling over Napier, New Zealand.
I've never flown a glider with the response of a Phoenix. It kind of becomes an extension of yourself. The more you work with it, the more it becomes part of you. I guess it's like any sport. People have their favorite skis, their favorite surfboard or tennis racket. Well, with the Phoenix, you've got a glider you can grow with. It just feels good.
This flight was from Mount Hiei in Japan. It was part of a demonstration trip around the world for Delta Wing kites.
I'm not surprised, but the sport is really catching on in every country we visited. I guess it's popular because it can blend so well with the other sports you're proficient in. I like skydiving. We wanted to try something a little different. We're high over Death Valley, California. We'll be right back. Here's some of my friends during a recent competition in the Canadian Rockies. As you can see, hang gliding adds quite a dimension to even skiing. Launching a hang glider in the snow can be difficult sometimes because of the variable wind conditions in the mountains. For example, if the wind is blowing lightly down the mountain, pilots need a second person wearing snow skis to act as a pusher to help to get the glider in the air. Hey, somebody get this dog off me. Flying in snow flurries, like skiing, has its hazards because of the reduced visibility and depth perception. Everything looks very flat. However, when flying, it is really beautiful to see those snowflakes drifting towards you and suddenly parting about your body and glider. Still another sport, water skiing, takes on a whole new attitude when combined with a glider. Although the Phoenix was foremost designed for performance, it has been carefully stressed even for towing. Duddlewing kites have been towed behind cars, boats, snowmobiles, motorcycles, trains, you name it. They've taken off on foot, roller skates, skateboards, skis, even ice skates. Back in Southern California, this flyer gains altitude quickly in the mountains above Sonora. We've seen flyers gain more than 5,500 feet from their point of takeoff.
Sunday morning brings us miles from
Robert Reed does a nice wing over high above Escape Country in Southern California. One of the Phoenix's many fine features is the Ram Air leading edge pocket. This pocket creates improved airfoil, allowing the glider to fly slower with a better sink rate. In heavy turbulence, the pocket stays inflated, especially in full left dive, allowing a quick dive recovery with a minimum loss of altitude. Hang gliding is really the ultimate sport. Hang gliders have traveled for over 30 miles cross country and have remained aloft for over 12 hours. Variometers, airspeed indicators, altimeters, and other instruments are becoming more and more popular. In the near future, we're looking forward to some 100-mile flights.
Children.
Most every human, since the beginning of man, has looked skyward and admired the graceful soaring beauty of the birds, the simplicity of the type of flight they experience, and the freedom of their environment, the sky. At last, hang gliders provide the means for man to join his friends, the birds, and share with them the freedom of the sky.
Gliders like the Phoenix, hang glider pilots are opening up a new frontier the screaming jets and high-flying rocket pilots will never experience. Hang gliding is definitely here to stay, and Delta Wing is proud to be involved.